Hello everyone, welcome to episode 2 of Life of Church Before the Storm, part 2. I guess, let's just continue where we were.
Later, Skip.
Later.
Looks like David's here. Awesome. Would have loved this shit. Another letter to Max that I'll never send. At least Journal Max won't abandon me the way Real Max did.
It's about damn time.
David, please.
Your mother and I have been talking.
Can we do this later? I don't think I can handle another fight right now.
And who do you expect to handle things for you? Your mother?
I don't need a conversation. Not with Sergeant Asshat here. I just need some space.
Do not use that language with your mother.
Or what, David? What will you do?
You do not want to test me. Maybe if you try listening to me, instead of fighting me about everything, you might actually learn a thing or two.
What? How to be a soldier?
Soldiers put family and future above self and now. Getting kicked out of school? That's what losers do.
You had a scholarship, Chloe. Do you know what that means? What kind of opportunity you gave up? Do you want to work at the diner? Someone needed my help. Who? Your friend Rachel? Because I think the daughter of the DA is going to be just fine. I need your help. Me, your mother. We need to get our own house in order. Right now, what I need most of all is for the two of you to start getting along.
Chloe, I don't want to fight. I care about your mother very much, and you too. I'd like for us to start over. What do you say?
Are you still going to date my mom?
Of course.
And will you still be coming to our house?
I plan to.
Then I say, go fuck yourself.
That's what I thought. From now on, I will be assisting your mother in a few areas. Like making sure that you are no longer abusing drugs or alcohol. Chloe, I'd like you to empty your pockets and place all your belongings on the trunk of the car.
What the fuck?
If we are going to start over, we have to know that you are not abusing drugs. If you're not, you should be eager for the chance to prove it.
Mom, you can't be serious.
David and I have discussed it, and we feel this is the only way for us all to have a fresh start.
Let's go, Chloe. Quit stalling.
I'm going to refuse. Because I feel like Chloe never did this.
Sure. Here you go. Show me your warrant, asshole.
You watch too much television. Your refusal to comply is as good as an admission.
I admit to you being a fascist, and I don't take orders from fascists. What happened to trust being a two-way street?
That was before you were expelled.
Somewhere along the way, we lost our trust. This is not the way to get it back. Not at all.
Okay.
That's it? She's basically admitted her guilt, and you're letting her off the hook?
I am not letting her off the hook. I am trying to find a way for us to move on. We need a new beginning. A new chapter. One that will involve the three of us together.
What does that mean?
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
No fucking way!
Chloe, after everything that's happened, I'm at a loss. I need help.
Exactly. We need a firmer hand steering this ship.
Talk to me, Chloe. Tell me what you're feeling.
Mom, I know I fucked up. I'm a fuck up. I'm sorry.
Are you sorry? You don't even know what you're apologizing for.
I've been shutting you out even though I've needed you, and you need me, and I know that. But this is not the answer.
It's the only answer I have, Chloe.
It's just
a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me. I'm sorry I took that for granted.
I'm not choosing anyone over anyone else. It's about the three of us having a home together.
It'll be better than you think, Chloe. Once everything's running smoothly, you'll see what a stable home can be like.
Why haven't you told your parents about Max at all? Hurry up.
Hey!
There is no home. Not if he's there.
Chloe.
Let her go. She'll come home as soon as her tantrum is over.
Indeed. I feel like they just used this same shot from the actual Life is Strange game from episode 1.
How do you know which way is up when your whole life has been turned upside down? Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left? Ugh. This thing is a mess. But maybe I can fix it. If this beast will ever run again, the first thing it needs is a new battery. Guess I was pretty pissed at Rachel last night. Amazing that someone I just met could have made me this angry. I guess I'll never ride one of these again. That's so awesome. You're a long way from the beach. Wow. Shitty ride, drug dealer. Really thought crime paid better. What are you trying to hide under their hood?
This must be my first time doing this.
Here we go, the pick of the litter. American Rust. Sounds about right. This thing needs more love than I can give right now. In the meantime, maybe I can spruce it up a bit. Probably a good idea to cover over this with something. Maybe there's another light bulb I can put in here. Something else to fix inside the truck. While an escape hatch could be nice, I should probably cover over this massive hole.
Okay, now can we go and look for stuff? Okay. So, it's three things we need to look for.
Okay. Let's see what else this trash heap has to offer. No, not going over there.
This might make the perfect cover for that torn seat.
Okay, that's one.
These magazines are so gross. Who would look at this?
Four. Or something.
I guess there's one place left.
Now if this is a Vortex Club, I wouldn't mind joining. Cigarettes. Do I want to tell my fellow sailors of the seven trash heaps? Got it.
Very treasure.
That there isn't buried treasure there.
Light bulb.
You might not work. Then again, I hardly ever work.
Okay, back to the truck. Thank you.
can hang here, but I get to pick the tunes. Okay?
Oh, so you're
the talk.
This thing looks like a rusted out shopping cart. Probably drives like one too. That's if it ever does drive, which seems questionable. Still, how sweet would that be? Yeah?
Bryce, it's Frank.
Oh. Hey, Frank. What's up?
Yeah, just checking in to see how you're doing.
Really?
No. Listen, we've got some business to discuss. Where can we meet?
What about? Like, drugs?
Bryce.
I'm hanging out in the junkyard, north of town.
The junkyard? That's great. Stay there, I'll see you soon.
Okay. And Frank, I'm not in trouble or anything, right?
I don't know. Did you do anything you should be in trouble for?
Like, in general, or to you?
I'll see you soon.
Time for a hard-earned smoke break. Does your truck look like an aquarium on wheels? Didn't think so. You only get one chance to make a first expression. This'll give intruders something to think about.
My time. I'm trying.